Hello everyone, in today's video I will be showing you how to create a switch using which you can switch the values on YTD, QTD and MTD. I have even created videos prior on YTD, QTD, MTD, so I won't be using much time on it. So let's start. So while working on date, as I even specified in my previous video, you have to find the max date or the recent date. So let us first find that. So parenthesis, within that you have to find max of order date. Click on OK. Let us see what the value of recent date is. Click on exact date. So this is the exact date or the max date. Now let us find the first day of the year. So first day of year. So date trunc, you have to truncate date at year. Truncate date part should be year and date should be recent date. Click on OK. Let us convert it into date. Now let us find first day of the month as well as first day of the quarter. So let's duplicate and edit. So I want to find first day of quarter. So even change here, quarter, and let us duplicate again to find first day of the month. Click on edit. So I want first day of the month. Click on OK. Now let us drag and drop to see what exactly the value is. Just select all, right click and click on exact date. So the first day of the month is 1st of December, which is correct. First day of the quarter is 1st of October and first day of the year is 1st of Jan 2019. So the values of first dates are coming out to be correct. Now let us find the values of sales, that is YTD sales, QTD and MTD sales. So create a calculated field for that. YTD, if order date is greater than equal to first day of year and order date is less than equal to recent date, then return sales and click on OK. So YTD value is ready. In the same way, we will be find QTD and MTD values. So just duplicate it, right click, edit, just rename it to QTD. This would be first day of the quarter. Click on OK. Again duplicate it to find MTD value. So duplicate, edit, this is MTD, and again you have to change this value, that is first day of the month. Click on OK. Let me clear the screen. Let us drag and drop YTD, QTD and MTD value. Now let us even see the month on month split of the MTD, QTD, YTD values. So for that, just drag and drop order date, filter out the maximum year. Okay. Now drag and drop order date inside rows and convert it into month year. Just convert it into discrete. So we have months, month by month split of MTD, QTD and YTD values. Now let us move to our main part, that is creating switch. So for switch we will be making use of parameter. This is my switch. Let us keep the data type as float. If the value is 1, then I will be displaying it as YTD. If the value is 2, then just display it as QTD. And if the value is 3, then display it as MTD. Click on OK. So we have created a switch of data type float. Now let's see the value of the switch. Okay, so we have created a switch. Now we have to create a calculated field that will switch the value with respect to this selection. So create a calculated field switch value use case for parameter switch. When the value is 1, then return YTD, because 1 is for YTD. When the value is 2, then it will return QTD, and when it is 3, then it will return MTD value, and click on OK. Now drag and drop the value inside measure values. So YTD is selected, that's why YTD is displaying. If you select QTD, then value will be with respect to QTD, and if MTD is selected, then the value will be shown with respect to MTD. Now let me clear the screen and drag switch value inside text and switch inside text as well. Edit. Select all. I want Trebuchet MS bold. I want the first text should be with a greater font, and this should be with lighter color. Click on OK. Entire view, align it to center. So let's have a look. If YTD is selected, then total YTD value will be displayed. If QTD, then QTD value will be selected, and if it is MTD, then MTD value will be shown. So that's it for the video. Thank you.